Now we are standing in the habitation area of Kodumanal. This particular habitation area covers almost 30 acres of this particular place in and around me that has been considered as prominent and most centric habitation site of the Kodumanal civilization. You can see various and numerous potsherds over here, all broken pottery ware. And here you can see this is actually the quartz that has been used to make white color beads out of this. So what do they do with these beads? Actually, these beads and other colors of beads, like green beads and red beads, are there. And such beads have been these stones are imported from places like Gujarat and from Mangalore and nearby place called Kidangai. And this is actually a green stone from which green stones, green beads have been made. And see, this is actually a bead over there here. And this is actually some sort of engineering pottery that would have been used for some other purposes. And this is again a white color, crystal clear quartz. And another thing is, I have got actually an iron ore thing, or it's like a, what do you call this? Is actually a sludge from iron ore furnace. This sludge is actually the drained, unused part of a furnace that has been wiped off before taking off the pure iron. So this thing is a most significant consideration to be done here, because Kodumanal was full of iron smelting plants, iron smelting units. We had iron ore mines over here nearby, and these ores have been taken here and smelted. And iron and steel, most importantly steel, it's not iron, it's steel, has been manufactured here and has been exported to the Roman Empire. Here we, I have said that there is a Noyal River beside this place. This Noyal River has connections, there is a way which takes us from this Kodumanal to the Muziris, what we call as Muziris in Kerala right now. And the entire region was governed by Cheras. Such one prominent Chera king is Cheran Sengutuvan. And during his period, the Muziris was a bustling harbor where the ships from the Roman Empire used to come from Rome to Alexandria in Egypt. From there they take the Nile, they come to a place called Quift. From there they used to cross the desert from Quift to Bernaki, what we call as Bernaki, that's mentioned in ancient Roman texts. From Bernaki they used to take the Red Sea, and they wait for the monsoon season to set in here in Kerala, where the wind turns favorable for the sails to be set there, and they take the route to Muziris. From Muziris, as actually a commercial trade hub, from Muziris all goods from these places, from such industrial sites like Kodumanal, used to be taken to Muziris, and from there it has been exported to Rome, Athens and other countries from there. And the extent of trade actually caused a trade deficit in Rome. Even in the there's a book called Periplus of Erythraean Sea, wherein there is a text that mentions, oh, the treasure, gold in the treasures of Rome are vast vanishing because of the thirst of Roman ladies for gold and other precious stones. We are losing our gold to Muziris. Such Muziris was again a civilization port where the goods from this industrial center was taken to Muziris, and from there it was exported over there. How do we conclude Roman did trade with this Kodumanal? We have got lots and lots of remnants and broken Roman jars over here. These Roman jars were used to store olive oil, they were used to store wines. It means that none of our civilization used to consume wine, and there is no traces of olive oil since then. The Romans left this area. Then how did those come in? These areas had a Roman settlement. The Romans came here, they got a settlement grant from the local king, they settled there, they procured the goods from Kodumanal, they themselves transported the goods to Muziris, and from there they exported them to Rome on Roman ships. And these Roman and Roman ships are yet another part of a big, big, big deal. And they need a separate several episodes of YouTube videos. So again, this thing, how did Kodumanal come into limelight is, as I told you in the last video, ASI scientist, actually an ASI officer came here and he excavated this thing and he threw the limelight to this region. So since then, the people started digging up several cane circles here in search of treasures. Once, what happened is, when ASI came here and they excavated, they got a skeleton which was seated in Padmasana. Right? Since the skeleton was seated in Padmasana and the local people also saw that skeleton, they stopped digging up all the cane circles in because of some fear. Since then, the site is extremely protected, not only by the government authorities, by the local people as well. This particular site is actually a private property where I am standing here and giving you this video. This private property, if ASI or some other people come and ask for excavation on this private property, the locals will never pose any opposition. They will grant the site for excavation. The excavation will be completed and the locals are really proud. They are extremely proud of their soil. They actually, I just talked to a person called Santosh here, who has lots and lots of immense knowledge of this particular area. And even he has got hundreds of artifacts with him that he unearthed from this area. And even we have Tamil Brahmi scripts, he's having Tamil Brahmi scripts with him. And so this site is not only protected by government, by the local people also are having equal part in conserving this heritage site here. Now, one point to mention is, not in any other southern Indian state or even as India as a whole, here this is the only site which has got 1200 Brahmi script specimens. That's whopping amount. And one point to mention is, only 5% of the Kodumanal has been excavated so far. Almost some 50 to 55 pits have been dug by various excavation agencies, and there are lots and lots and lots of things to be digged and that has to be brought into limelight from this Kodumanal site. And Mr. K. Rajan of French Institute has played a prominent role in bringing this region's most spectacular facts to the global arena. Okay, see you in the next video.